Hello, and welcome to another T-Studio demo. This video will show you how you can plot shadows cast from objects with the sun as your light source. As usual, all our perspective drawings are being done with these materials. In my first light and shadow video, I showed you how to locate a light source within the field of vision, something like a lamp. The drawing included adding something called a radiating point and the light source, which was found directly above that radiating point. What happens if your light source is much larger? For instance, the sun. Because the sun is so large, the rays of light do not radiate in the same way. They appear more parallel, and shadows actually use a vanishing point on the horizon line. I will label this vanishing point an SVP for shadow vanishing point. And let me demonstrate how this is done. For this first drawing, I will work with negative sun. That means that the sun is behind the viewer, making the cast shadows move toward the horizon line. Just like you have to locate vanishing points to help draw convincing volumetric shapes, I also need a shadow vanishing point, and I can locate this anywhere on the horizon line. And since I want the shadows to move to the left, I will place the SVP to the left of my box on the horizon line. Now I need to locate the sun in relationship to the scene. For a negative sun drawing, it will be found directly below my SVP. For long shadows, you place the sun closer to the horizon line. And for shorter shadows, you put it further away. But it needs to stay directly below the SVP. And here I've marked it and drawn a little sun. The next step is to draw lines from each of the bottom corners of my box back to the shadow vanishing point. Then, from the top corners of this box, I will draw a line to the light source, or sun. And where our sets of lines intersect, we will have points which we can then connect, and there we will have our cast shadow. Okay, so to finish up this page, I'm going to draw a couple of poles so that you can see again how to complete this technique for doing cast shadows. This one on the right, again, from the bottom of the object, you draw it up towards the shadow vanishing point, from the top of the object down to the light source, and you complete the shadow. For the second pole, I'm going to place it over here on the left of the box, and I want to set it to a place where the shadow, as it's cast, will land onto the box, and you can kind of see how that's accomplished. Now, let's see how to draw positive sun. This means that the sun is located in front of the viewer and not behind. For positive sun, the process is the same. But instead of locating the sun below the horizon line, I'm going to place it above, and it will appear in our drawing. This will make our cast shadows move towards us, and will also add shade to the front planes of our box. So, to review, we add a shadow vanishing point, locate the sun directly above the SVP, connect the bottom corners to the SVP. The corresponding top corners of our object are then connected to the light source. And as we go, we want to make sure that we are carefully keeping track of our lines. I think I had a mistake as I went, but luckily I caught it before I started adding the shadow. We plot those points that help us draw our shadow line, and then we finish it up. Finally, let me show you what you can do if the sun is located so high that you can't draw it on your paper. For this method, we will employ the Brewer technique. Now, if you don't know what the Brewer method is, you might want to watch my short video on how to locate vanishing points off your paper by using that method, and I'll include a link at the end of this demo. Like every drawing, I'm adding a shadow vanishing point on the horizon, but I want the sun somewhere off my paper. I add a series of points along my horizon line, starting at the SVP, and for my drawing, I put them about 1 inch apart. Then, somewhere close to the top of my paper, I add another horizontal line, and I'm going to mark off 7 units, but this time I will make them closer together. For my drawing, I think I set them at about 1/2 inch. Once those points are located, I connect each corresponding point to make a guide. And while drawing the lines that radiate down from the sun, they will follow the same angles as these guidelines, and this will give me the results that I want. Now, if your lines don't line up directly with these guidelines, that's okay. Just make sure that you place them so that they appear to converge in the same direction. And once you have your guide set, you can follow the same steps to locate your cast shadow. If you have found this video useful, consider liking or subscribing, and comments are always welcome. Thanks for watching, and happy drawing!